and deceased donor. So now, by now you must have understood who can be a donor. First of all, any person who is above 18 years of age can be a donor, who voluntarily authorizes the removal of his organ or tissue during his her lifetime. So living donor mein kya hoga? He voluntarily gives a form or he gives his consent that he wants to donate his organ. Now, who can be a donor? Again, continue over here. Deceased donor. Now, what is a deceased donor? Donor after his death. Anyone, regardless of age, race, gender, can become an organ and tissue donor after his or her death. That is the brainstem and the cardiac or the cardiac death. Now, in this, now a person has died. Suppose a person is dying dying of accident. He is not still dead. He is in the hospital. He is on the ventilator, and his brain has died. And the doctors are saying that he cannot come out of this, but the heart is still beating. So, in this, who will give the consent that organs have to be donated? Their parents or the near relatives. Consent of the near relative. So here, near relative or a person in lawful position of the dead body is required. Lawful position matlab unki wife hogi ya fir husband hai to uska husband hoga. So lawful relative or parents, then medical suitability for donation is determined at the time of the death. This is also very important, whether he is medically suitable for the donation of the organs or not. Now, how can I be a donor? What is the process of taking the donor pledge? Now, this is again very important. As I told you that for the cadaver, that is the body donation. For body donation, we get the people, they are coming, old people, they come to my department and they said ki humko apni body donate karni hai. So we give them a form. I have a form and they fill up the form, and these forms are kept with me, as well as one form is given to them. And if the body really comes, then we give certificate to his or her relatives that he has donated his body. So in the same way, there is a pledge for the organs. That is, how can be a donor of the organ? What is the process of the donor pledge? So in the case of the organs, today is the organ we are talking about, mainly about the organs over here. So anyone can be a donor by expressing his her wish in the authorized organ and tissue donation form. So here we have a form that is called as form number 7 as per THOA, that is Transplantation Human Organ Act, or signing up with website www.noto.nic.in and register themselves as a donor. So samajh mein aa rahi hai ye baat sabko? Everyone should understand that now it's very easy. If you want to become a donor, that is a live donor, or the donor after death, first of all, you can take a donor pledge. So taking the donor pledge is very easy. You have to fill up the form. You have to go onto this website. You will get a form, and then you can fill up the form, and then again return to the download it to the, you can put up in the website again. Then donors should fill up the form number 7 and send a signed copy to NOTO as mentioned below. Now, what is NOTO? I'll tell you. NOTO is the National Organ and Tissue Transplant Organization. So the first and the topmost organization in India. We have only one organization, that is in Delhi, that is the fourth floor NIOP building, Safdarjung Hospital campus, New Delhi 110029. So this is the only place where the organs, it is noted, that is the anyone who wants to donate the organ, who has made a pledge, they are registered in that NOTO. So this organization is there, the main center for the organ donation. That is, I'll repeat once again, the National Organ and Tissue Transplant Organization, that is called as NOTO. Now after that, we see that here we see that after the taking the pledge, we get a card, and that card is the donor card. Now, this donor card, a person will ask, do I need to carry my donor card always? Yes, you can carry your donor card. All the donors should carry the donor cards along with them so that it is helpful for the health professionals. So donor card inke paas bhi rahega every time it is with them, as well as we have the registry in the noto that this person is liking to donate his organ. Then can a person without a family register for the pledge? This is also important question. So yes, for this also the answer is yes. He can register for the pledge, but donor need to preferably inform the person closest to him in life. Though he does not have his family closest to him, he must be having a friend. So a friend of long standing or a close colleague about his decision of pledging. So he has to tell somebody that he has made a pledge. Now, what is the benefit to donor's family or donor about after the donation of organ? This is also a very important thing you should know, that do you have any benefit? Suppose if I am filling up the donor, I'm giving the donor pledge of having a donor card, then afterwards, what benefit do I have? Or my family, is it benefiting from there? So now you listen to this very carefully. This is a universal benefit for the mankind. Donation is of overall help for the society as a whole. Donation of an organ or tissue provides an unparalleled opportunity to give someone a second chance of life. So here you do not have a benefit for your family or for yourself. You are giving a benefit to the mankind, to the society, as well as you are giving a chance for the second life. A second person is getting a chance to live with your organs. Now after this comes the religious issues. Now this also is an important issue again. Are there any religious objections to donate organs and tissues? No. None of the religions object to donate organs and tissues. Rather, they are all promoting and supporting this noble cause. Still, if anyone has any doubt, they may discuss with their spiritual or religious leader or the advisor. So this there should be no issue about the of any of the religion. This I have made it clear, and they can go to the spiritual or the religious leader before they want to make a pledge or want to donate the organ. Now coming to the organ transplant data. Now organs are donated, living person has donated the organ, then the person after dead, that is the brainstem death or the cardiac death, they have donated the organs. The organs are with the nation, that is with the government. So how the data is kept, I will tell you all these things one by one. First is organ transplant data. In India, there is a growing need of organ and tissue transplant due to a large number of organ failure. Every year, following number of people need organ tissue transplant as per organ specified. So here we see that around 2,50,000 of the kidneys are needed every year in India for the transplantation. But we do not get 2,50,000 of kidneys as donation, live as well as cardiac together. But this much people are needing it. Then cornea, 1 lakh of cornea are needed in India per year. This is I'm talking per year. Then liver, around 80,000 people are waiting for the liver transplant, and heart around 50,000 people. Then here donors with this is again very important, which you should know, donors with transmissible disease. Now, if any of the donor is coming and he has got any transmissible disease, so can we take his organs or no? So here what we see is that our donors screen to identify if they have a transmissible disease. So this is very, very important. Any donor, we do not know whether he has any disease or no. They are screened. Blood of all the potential donors is tested to rule out the transmissible diseases and viruses such as HIV and hepatitis. So if a person is having HIV or hepatitis, then his organ cannot be donated, but specifically in some cases, which I'll tell you later. Now, can I be a donor if I have any existing medical condition? Medical condition, for example, किसी को अस्थमा है, किसी को backache है, and it is an existing condition. So, can he become a donor? Yes, definitely he can become a donor. In most circumstances, such person can be a donor. Having a medical condition does not necessarily prevent a person from becoming an organ or tissue donor. Here, in very rare cases, that is the organs of donors with HIV or hepatitis C have been used to help others with the same condition. Samajh mein aayi baat? Here, see, any medical condition, we can donate the body. But if a person is having hepatitis or HIV, then the organs of these people can be donated to the people who are having this condition, that is HIV or hepatitis. So HIV ka patient hai, usko agar organ transplant ki zarurat hai, to we can give him the organ of a person suffering from HIV. So this we can do. Now, this is again important question. Can I be an organ donor if I have been rejected to donate the blood? So, kabhi kisi zamane mein main reject hui thi blood donate. So, yes, you can be a donor. The decision will be taken up by the specialist. This will be made by the specialist, that is the professional. Then specific reason why it has not been possible to donate the blood in the past, such as in the past, you must have been, a person has got rejected because he must be having anemia at that time, or he must have had received a blood transfusion recently, or he must be having hepatitis at that time, or a simple cold or the medication that he is taking can prevent him from blood donating. So at once in a while in the past, he was not allowed to donate the blood. This simply does not mean that he cannot become a donor. He can be a donor. Then how can I help in increasing the organ donation? This is very, very important. Everyone can help by becoming a donor and talking to your family about your decision of saving the lives of others. So this is a very good work for the welfare of the people or the welfare of humanity. Promoting donation by motivating people at workplace, then at your community, then at the place of worship, ladies are going, and in your civic organizations also. You can talk over there and you can help us in increasing the number of the organs to be donated. Then here we see the legal and the ethical issues. So what are the legal issues and the ethical issues? What is the National Organ, Human Organ and Tissue Removal and Storage Network? I'll be telling you the whole of the network, how the organs are taken and where they are stored. So the central government has established a National Human Organ and Tissue Removal and Storage Network named NOTO. This I've already described. What is NOTO? That is National Organ and Tissue Transplant Organization. Then NOTO will have 5 regional networks. So, ab samajh mein aa rahi hai baat? First, at the highest level in Delhi, what is there? There is NOTO. That is national level, Organ Tissue Transplant Organization. So, this will, under it will be working 5 regions. So, that means whole of India is divided into 5 regions. That is the ROTO, Regional Organ and Tissue Transplant Organization. Now, these 5 regions, under them will be the states. Each region of the country will develop SOTO. SOTO means the state organ and tissue transplant organization in every state. So this SOTO is present in every state, and a few states together they are working under the ROTO in this manner. And then each of the states will have a hospital. Each hospital of the country related to transplant activity, whether as retrieval or transplant, has to link with ROTO through the Roto Soto as a part of the national networking. So it is becoming the national networking in this manner. So this is the network of the organ donation. First, at the highest level, there is the Noto. Then under it are the Roto. These are five in number. Then Soto, all the states, and then the hospitals in each of the state. In one state, there may be in all the cities, there may not be the hospital, but in one state, there may be few hospitals which are which have the retrieval transplant centers. Then what is national registry? Organ transplant registry. The organ transplant registry shall include demographic data about the patient waiting for the transplant. So here there is a waiting list of the people who want a transplant. Then there is a donor data. Then there is a hospital data. So donor data means the live as well as the organs which they have. Now in this donor data, we have a related donor, then other than near related donor, then the swab donors and the deceased donor, that is after the death, and the hospital. Now, tissue registry. The tissue registry shall include demographic information of the tissue donor and site of tissue retrieval or donation. Again, this is also registered. Now, organ donor pledge registry. So there is also a register which I have already told you, that is the pledge registry. The National Organ Donor Register is there. It is a computerized database which records the wishes of the people who have pledged for organ and tissue donation. Now in this, one more thing, what is the legal position on organ donation? Now organ transplantation and donation is permitted by law and covered under the Transplantation of Human Organ Acts 1994. In 2011, amendment of the act also brought in donation of human tissues, thereby calling the amendment act, that is the Transplantation of Human Organ and Tissues Act 2011. So pehle usko organ donation bolte the, abhi organ as well as the tissue donation act. Whom do I report in case I find that there is a sale of the organs? Ab ye bhi bahut important baat hai. Sale of organs tum logo ne suna hoga, picture dekha hoga, movies mein aaya tha ki organs nikal lete hain koi doctor and then sale hota hai. So this is very important if you come to know. Now in case anybody submitting false records or any other delinquency should be reported to the appropriate authority of the state government. So there is the authority of the state government called as Department of Health and Family Welfare. Any hospital authorization committee or a person can approach to the state appropriate authority. The appropriate authority can file a case against the party. Now here we see there are some punishments for this. Now removal of an organ without authority. Here there is a person will get imprisonment of 10 years as well as a fine of 20 lakhs. Then removal of organ without authority penalty. For RMP is the registered medical practitioner, to uska kya registration cancel karenge for 3 years ke liye. First offense, deregistration for 3 years, and second offense, again he's making the offense, then permanent deregistration will be done. Then we see commercial dealing in organs, falsification of documentation. Here we see that the imprisonment will be 5 to 10 years, and again the fine will be of 20 lakhs. Then any violation of THOA, 5 years imprisonment and 20 lakhs of fine is he will have to pay. Then what are the ethical concerns with the, what are the ethical concerns with the living unrelated donations? This is important. अगर कोई रिलेटिव नहीं है फिर भी ऑर्गेन डोनेट करना चाहता है तो यू विल हैव टू गिव अ थिंक ओवर इट. सो डॉक्टर्स आर कंसर्न्ड विद द पॉसिबल इमोशनल फाइनेंशियल एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ द डोनर्स बाय रेसिपिएंट फैमिलीज एंड आल्सो by the transplant hospitals. So doctors are worried that with the increased demand of the organs, the right of the poor donor to live with dignity may be abused. So this you must have understood. What I'm trying to tell is that people may, rich people, they may exploit the poor people that tum donate karo, hum paise de denge. So this doctors, they usually take care about it. Does Government of India financially support the organ transplant? Yes. Government of India has started National Organ and Transplant Program, under which patients below poverty line are supported for the cost of transplant and as well as the cost of immunosuppressants after transplant for 1 year. So this you should understand very nicely, that if anybody needs an organ transplant, government is there to help the people. Then renal transplant in all the public hospitals is subsidized as per Government of India policy. So this also I'm making you aware that these things are not difficult now. Only thing, the approach has to be properly made and you will get everything from the government. Is it possible? Is it possible to jump the waiting list if you are rich, well connecting and influential? Isn't it an important question? Yes. Okay. No. In India, the waiting list is based on predetermined criteria, which includes the date of registration and the medical criteria. Medical criteria matlab, if the person is very ill and he needs a transplant, suppose of kidney, immediately, otherwise he will die. So is condition mein usko samne le sakte, otherwise there is a proper waiting list and the organs are transplanted according to the waiting list. Here the wealth, race or gender of a person on the waiting list will not have any effect. Now, is it right to remove a healthy organ from a living person and give it to another? Is it correct? Organ transplantation is undertaken only as a life-saving treatment. It is best for the transplant team to decide, keeping in mind the two issues of doing no harm to the donor and doing good to the recipient. Then organs and tissue transplants. Who will tell the donor about the transplant process? There is a process. So transplant coordinator and treating registered medical practitioners. So there are hospitals in which there are the different sections. They will tell the people about the process of the transplant. Now, insurance, medical insurance, aajkal sabhi log karate hain. Is there medical insurance cover for organ transplant cost? Nowadays, yes. Many insurance companies are covering the cost related to the transplant. It will be better to be sure when you are going for the medical insurance. So keep in mind, jab medical insurance aap log karwate ho na, to see ki tumhara tumko agar kabhi transplant ki zarurat padti hai, to it should be covered in that. Now, what is the protocol to maintain the waiting list? As per the protocol, patients who require cadaver organs are put in the waiting list. But in India, number of patients requiring the organs are more as compared to the numbers of organs available. So hamare jo organs rehte hai, wo nearly jaldi khatam ho jate hai, because waiting list apni bahut zyada rehti hai and the organs donation kam hai. So I am taking up this program to make you aware that you all can donate the organs. When a person is alive, he will donate his organ to his relative or to his nearby death only when it is necessary. But otherwise, after the death of a person, they can very well make a wish or they can pledge for themselves that they can donate their organs so that their organs live for a second life in another person. Now, two types of waiting list are there in this. One is the urgent waiting list and another is the regular waiting list. Urgent waiting list, I've made you understand, patient agar ekdam ill hai and we have to put him first. So that will be urgent, and regular waiting list is based on the medical criteria, and these criteria are different for different purpose. For kidney transplant, the criteria is usually the number of dialysis, kitne dialysis uske hue, so this will. Now, what is the protocol for organ distribution? This I have made you understand before also. The organs would be distributed locally within the state first. If there is no match found, they are then offered regionally and then nationally until a recipient is found. So every attempt is made to utilize the donor organ. Jaise brain dead ho gaya and humko bahut sare organs, if a parent or a relative is wishing ki aap organs le sakte ho, if a person has met an accident, to wo wale organs itne sare, to then it is talked with the nation where they are needed the most, to wahan bheje jate hain organs and they are utilized at the earliest. Now here comes how are donated organs matched, this is important, with the patients. Now many medical factors need to match to ensure a successful organ transplant. First is the blood group, then organ size, then for the kidneys, important factor is the tissue matching. The best results can be achieved if the perfect kidney matches there. So kidney match agar best barabar hai na, perfect kidney match, then the results are also best in this. Now what is a living donor organ donation? This I've already explained to you, that is the kidney. Then the living donor may pancreas, then the liver, small intestine ka part. Then can I donate organ when I am still alive? This I've already made you understand, yes. And the organs I've showed you, the organs just now, which you can, that is the kidney, liver, small intestine ka part, these you can be transplanted when the person is living. What are the different types of living organ donation? Types of living organ. One is the living near related hoga, wo apne near related ko dega. Then second hoga, living non-near related organ. डोनर मतलब रिलेशन में नहीं होगा वो तो भी डोनेट कर पाएगा. थर्ड इज अ स्वैप डोनर. नाउ आई विल मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज अ स्वैप डोनर. स्वैप डोनर मतलब दो रेसिपिएंट्स बैठे हैं, लाइक टू पीपल, टू पेशेंट सफरिंग फ्रॉम किडनी फेलियर एंड दोनों को किडनीज चाहिए एंड उसका जो रिलेटिव है उसका किडनी मैच नहीं हो रहा है एंड दूसरा जो पेशेंट है उसका भी जो रिलेटिव है उसका किडनी, सो ऐसे इंटरचेंज करेंगे उनको डोनर्स को. तो एक डोनर की किडनी दूसरे इसमें जाएगी एंड पहले वाले की दूसरे वाले पेशेंट में जाएगी. सो दिस इज यानी उनको क्रॉस करेंगे रेसिपिएंट्स डोनर्स को, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द स्वैप डोनर्स. Now, will I become medically unfit after the organ donation? No, donor is not medically unfit. No, donor is not medically unfit for any purpose. For any purpose. However, in certain situation, living organ donor is treated differently. Like in the armed forces, an organ donor is not taken as normal and donor faces issues related to promotion in the job. So only in the armed forces this is, otherwise a person is fit, the donor is considered as a fit person. Then who will receive my organ? Ab ye wali baat hai ki organ to de diya, ab uske baad mein who will receive my organ, people may ask. So your vital organs will be transplanted into those individuals who need them most. So gift of life, organs are the gift of life, are matched to the recipients on the basis of the medical suitability, urgency of the transplant, duration on the waiting list and geographical location. So according to this, your organ will be donated to the person. You will not know to whom it is donated. Who can give consent for organ donation after brainstem death? So here, this I've already said, the consent will be given by a parent, spouse, son, daughter, brother or sister. Okay? By signing a consent form, the family says that they do not have any objection or to the removal of organs from the body of their loved one. So this is a legal document. Now, who can give consent? This I've already finished. How quickly should the donated organs by a deceased donor be transplanted to the other? So here I've given a data over here. So heart, when it is removed, it has to be get transplanted within 4 to 6 hours. Then lungs within 4 to 8 hours. Getting my point? पेशेंट मर गया है उसका हम लोग हार्ट निकाल रहे हैं तो इट हैज टू बी ट्रांसप्लांटेड. वो सिर्फ डोनेट नहीं, ट्रांसप्लांट भी करना है इमीडिएटली विद इन 4 to 6 hours. देन लंग्स विद इन 4 to 8 hours. इंटेस्टाइन 6 to 10 hours. देन लिवर 12 to 15 hours. पैनक्रियास 12 to 24 hours. एंड किडनीज वी कैन ट्रांसप्लांट विद इन 24 to 48 hours. नाउ हियर इज इट पॉसिबल दैट आई कैन एक्सप्रेस माई विश टू डोनेट द organs to some people and not to others? No, you cannot express this that mera organ isko hi dene ka hai, yahi community ko dena hai ya yahi religion ko dena hai. It will be donated. If you are giving the organ, you have to donate it very freely, and there is no such condition that can be accepted in terms of potential recipients. You can cannot put this wish with us. If I carry a donor card, will my organ be taken out within my without my family being asked? No, again, if you have a donor card also, your family will definitely be asked before your organ is removed. The consent is mandatory from the person lawfully in possession of a dead body before donation can be carried out. If they refuse, then organ donation will not take place though you have a card. Is there any charge to my family for organ tissue donation? No, there is no charge, additional charge to family of potential organ donor. No charge. Potential donors need to be medically maintained in the ICU during the time of donation. Then from that time family agrees to donate organs and tissues, all charges are borne by the treating hospital, and donor family is not charged anything on it. So with this, I am ending my topic. Thank you all of you for your patient hearing, and I hope that you all have understood my things, and I hope that you have gained some knowledge from it. Thanks once again. Now I call upon Dr. Geetanjali for vote of thanks.
On behalf of Anatomy Department, Dr. Sanjay Brahm, Deshmukh Memorial Medical College, and all the respected Dr. P.R. Somoishi Sir for his valuable support and continuous encouragement to us and his precious time also. I thank respected Dr. A.T. Deshmukh Sir, Professor and Head of the Department of Pathology, for his valuable support and time that he has given to us. I thank our administrative officer, respected Dr. A.G. Pabande Sir, for his timely help. I thank all the technical assistance team of our college, without whom this webinar wouldn't have been conducted so smoothly. And finally, I thank you all the participants who have participated in this webinar. So thank you all. We will be sending the feedback form to you all before I have registered, and kindly fill kindly on the email, or your whatever emails you have given. and kindly send it through. And also, if any queries, that also you can send on the email. And the e-certificates will also be sent to you from our email. So thank you. All those people who have not sent their email address, please send it now, so that it will be convenient for us to communicate with you all and send the certificate also. So thank you.